Do you know your rights? Learn the law with us. Know your rights. Listen, ask, learn. Yes, this is your chance to educate yourself, empower yourself, and educate your community. Join with us today. Know your rights.
Welcome to Know Your Rights. So what comes to your mind when you hear counseling? Oh, that's for crazy people, huh? That's what we hear sometimes when we say to somebody you need counseling. Or some people will ask, what is counseling? Isn't that expensive? But we see, there are so many of us sometimes who need someone simply to listen to, or some others who have conditions such as severe stress, depression, or some phobias, and some couples who are going through, you know, ups and downs in their relationships that they could do with some professional help. So in this series of programs, we're here to explain you what is counseling, how can counseling help you, and how to reach for help, and when to reach for help, and of course, how you can use counseling to make your life better. So in order to do that, because you deserve the best, I have the best of the best joining with me in this series. He is Professor D.S. Ranawaka, who is the pioneer in counseling movement in Sri Lanka. Professor Ranawaka is the founder president of Sri Lanka National Institute of Professional Counselors, which is the leading umbrella organization in Sri Lanka for counselors and psychotherapists. He has also founded the Institute of Psychological Studies, Colombo, to provide professional training for counselors and psychotherapists in Sri Lanka. He's also the chief psychologist at the John Geyer Memorial Counseling and Psychotherapy Clinic in Colombo. He has also developed a code of ethics and standards for counseling training in Sri Lanka. Professor Ranawaka has conducted numerous workshops in the public and private sector, as well as non-governmental organizations, to educate the public as well as the professionals from all walks of life. Professor Ranawaka has also developed Sinhala terminology and published academic literature and books in Sinhala to disseminate psychology and counseling knowledge among Sri Lankans. He has obtained his MPhil from the University of Colombo in the field of anxiety disorders from the psychiatry department of the University of Colombo. He received clinical training at the psychology clinic of University of Queensland in Australia. So, Professor, I can go on talking about you forever, but I'm sure our fans want to talk to you and listen to you talking. So, welcome to Know Your Rights. And I'm really humbled that you're here to enlighten us on the subject of counseling today.
Yeah, it's a good opportunity because still counseling is a new concept in Sri Lanka, not like highly developed countries.
Yeah.
Then awareness or the about counseling. It is better to educate the mass what counselors do and what type of professional service they provide.
Yes.
And then general nature of counseling.
Yes.
Because somehow in Sri Lanka more people think psychology and counseling for mentally ill people.
Yes.
No, it is for ordinary people.
Yes.
Ordinary families.
Yes.
Students who learn higher education or in the schools. Even ordinary person, well-balanced person, may have financial problems or some future plans.
Yes.
Include counseling.
Include counseling, yes. So to begin with, can I ask you, what is counseling?
Actually, counseling is a helping service.
Yes.
But there are internationally accepted norms. It's confidential. It is confidential.
Yes.
That is why it's a barrier to give publicity to counseling.
Yes.
Because only counselor and the counselee knows.
Yes.
What they did.
Yes.
We can't pass it to the,
yes,
the mass.
Yes.
That is why counseling has an international problem.
Yes.
Giving some publicity.
Yes.
And professional association also have put some limitations.
Yes.
You can put commercial type advertisement.
Yes.
You can't conduct commercial type of workshops and programs.
Yes.
This is very professional.
Very professional, yes. So, what is the, in the Sri Lankan context, what is the need for counseling in the current society?
Yeah, actually the humans, whatever they are living in the Western country or Asian country, humans are humans.
Yes.
They have human problems.
Yes.
If you take family,
yeah,
internationally, it's a separate
universal. Family. It's a universal.
Universal.
Yes.
Then the family has family related problems.
Yes.
We'll say some disagreement,
yes,
misunderstanding, whatever. So this type of things. And even the among the workers,
yes,
factory, company, bank,
yes,
because individuals working with many people, they have individual issues,
yes,
interpersonal issues.
Yeah.
This will, if there is no such professional help to them, it's a problem in the industry or the office.
Yes.
Because good relationship.
Yes.
It's a very productive thing.
Yes.
In Sri Lanka, they have not given much attention to this type of things, but except apparel industry.
They do. Yes. Some in-house counseling.
By the
human resources.
Yeah.
Yes. Yes. So, who are the perfect candidates for counseling, and what type of people should receive counseling?
Actually, there is no age category or male, female. Related things. Humans are all same.
Yeah.
Anybody is suitable for counseling when they have some crisis.
Some crisis.
Maybe career related. Maybe family related.
Okay.
Maybe the sex related things.
Okay.
Maybe the day to day problem solving related things. For a learner, for how to prepare examination, how to organize things. Anybody is suitable for counseling.
Anybody is suitable.
Yeah. And especially we have to say some mild mental disorders.
What?
That is called anxiety disorders.
Okay.
It's a huge area.
Okay.
It includes many day-to-day difficulties.
Difficulties.
Yeah.
Okay.
You will not die, but uneasiness. Uneasiness about unnecessary sweating, unnecessary disturbance, difficulty to concentrate on things. That type of things.
Yeah. And can these diseases be cured by counseling, like any type of diseases?
Yeah. All mild mental disorders.
Mild mental disorders.
Yeah. Can be cured by the psychotherapy.
Okay. But some people have a myth that counseling is for people with mental disorders, like for crazy people, you know. Is that true?
Yeah. Actually, I don't know how it available in Sri Lankan society. People think counseling or going to a professional regarding any problem, they think it's not a good thing, because they think it's only mad people will go to counselors. Actually, real mad people are suffering from mental disorders.
Yes.
They are not coming to us.
Yes.
And we can't treat them also.
Yes.
They have to go to a psychiatrist.
Yes.
That is different.
That's a medical condition.
Yeah. Medical condition.
Yes.
Because if you suffer many years with mild psychological disorders.
Yes.
Many stresses, you will develop major illness.
Major illnesses.
It takes time.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
But it is vulnerable to bad things.
Bad things.
And especially behavioral problems.
Yes.
Habit formation, that type of things. Not disorders.
Not disorders.
But better to change.
Yes.
It is called, so you are happiness in your life. It is better to go to a professional counselor.
Yes.
You can achieve many things.
Yes. There is a myth in the society, I mean, I don't know if it's true that counseling is expensive, professional counseling especially. Is that true?
Compared to medical services, if you go to a specialist,
right,
then you have to pay a little, the high amount. No? The same way if you go to a consultant, psychologist,
yes,
counseling professional, similar fee you have to pay. The reason is it takes more time,
yes,
especially family counseling.
Yes,
we have to listen to both parties separately,
yes,
husband and wife.
Yes,
because anybody have something to say, personal thing.
Yes,
then a professional counselor has to listen.
Yes,
it takes time.
Yes,
that is why in any country for family counseling give more. More time, nearly 2 hours or 2.5 hours.
Okay.
Then it is costly because
duration
of the professionals,
yes,
time and effort.
Yes.
It takes time.
Yeah.
It is little expensive.
Yeah. It's good that you brought up family counseling, because I'd like to talk about family counseling a bit more. How can couples or families benefit from family counseling?
Yeah, actually, as a legal officer, you know, in our courts, there is a long queue for divorce cases.
Yes.
Because more people don't know the family issue. It's a psychological issue. It's not a disorder.
Yes.
And it is not a legal matter.
Yes.
First.
Yes.
Then first they should go to a family counselor.
Yes.
Because now 35 years in our practice, we know more family issues are interpersonal problems.
Yes.
A difference of interest of both parties.
Yes.
And different life styles.
Yes.
Even food styles.
Yes.
So any individual, they have their own way.
Only.
Then when we put two people together, yes, these issues will come.
They should come. Yes.
That is why in America they say mediation, not counseling.
That's right. Yeah. Family mediation. Yeah.
Counseling is a very old word.
Now. Yes.
America says it's a mediation.
Yes.
Somebody must intervene and help. It's a professional help. And must be, it is confidential, because in family there are many sex issues.
Yes.
Right? Because even sexuality, it is different fields.
Different fields.
Different people has different ways.
Yes.
Different way of enjoying sex.
Yes.
Then this type of thing addressed by the professional counselor.
So how can people with sexual disorders benefit from counseling?
That is called sexual therapy.
Okay.
Psychotherapy. Psychotherapy. Like you females, you improve your beauty through beauty therapy. Same way, you can improve your sexual ability through sexual counseling and psychotherapy. There are many techniques.
Right.
It is like there are many medicine for disorders.
Okay.
The same way, there are many techniques to help people.
Okay. And what is the response like from the Sri Lankan people? Are they willing to come forward to receive this type of therapy?
Yeah, our experience is, because we started...
Is it still like a taboo?
Yeah.
Still?
We started about 35 years. Now it has much increase now. More people come.
More people come.
One is confidentiality is there.
Yeah.
And it is anonymous.
Yes.
And they can continue until they satisfy.
Right.
Because of these factors,
right?
They come for counseling, especially
right.
John Gay Memorial Counseling Center. We provide professional counseling in our members all over the country.
Right.
They also provide counseling in rural settings.
Okay.
And especially Army, Air Force, they also have these services.
Okay.
It's very useful to go to a professional counselor. If you have any difficulty, maybe psychological, maybe even some physical disorders.
Physical disorders?
Developed due to some stresses.
What kind of physical disorders, Professor?
Especially inability of moving hand or leg.
Okay.
And partial paralysis like things.
Okay.
And difficulty to start sleep or difficulty to continue sleep.
Continue sleeping? Okay.
Right? Various fears.
Okay.
Maybe if it is called phobias.
Yes.
You phobias. May be fear of rats.
Yes.
Okay, somebody say, what is this? It's a small matter. But you can't sleep because you dream rats.
Yes.
And maybe you are afraid of cockroaches. Cockroach is not harmful anymore.
Harmful, yeah.
But if you have such phobia.
Yeah.
Phobia is not fear.
Yeah.
Phobia is one deeper one.
Yes.
You dream cockroaches. You shout in the dream.
Yeah.
And you are always inquisitive whether cockroaches are there.
Yes.
Your main attention is not to your day-to-day work.
Yes.
Your attention is cockroaches.
Yes.
That is how it becomes a major problem.
It becomes a major problem, and then it begins to affect your
life,
day-to-day activity. It's also like OCD. Some people have OCD.
Yeah, yeah. No, when you have such fears for a longer period, you may develop obsessive compulsive disorder.
Yes.
That is also psychological disorder.
Yes.
No drug for these things.
Yes.
Obsessive means you start to repeat certain things.
Certain
washing
things.
Hands 30-40 times a day.
Yes.
Washing your face 30-40 times a day.
Yes.
Or washing plates 30-40 times.
Yes.
It's example for the obsessive compulsive disorder.
Yes. So we can see many people that even without knowing that this is a disorder, people are still experiencing it and they're going through some difficulties. But if they come to a counselor and receive professional help, they could probably
cure
them.
It is the easy thing. So OCD, like the maximum will take 1 month or 1.5 months.
Oh, really? Yes. About one to 2 months.
It is a permanent cure.
Permanent
cure. It will never come again.
Okay.
Even some sexual disorders, now inability of enjoying sex, that is through psychotherapy can cure within 2-3 months.
Without receiving medical help.
Actually, no medical help for these things.
Yeah.
Medical science is limited to bodily disorders.
Yes.
They have manufactured drugs for bodily ailments. What we discuss here is not bodily ailments.
Yeah.
But it looks like bodily.
Yeah, it's mostly to do with the mind.
Yeah.
The thinking.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, Professor, from your 35 years of experience, what type of people come to you? Like, what is the most common type of disorder?
We read a paper in Malaysia about Sri Lankan picture.
Okay.
Clientele.
Okay.
Actually, if you take young people.
Right.
More percentage come for memory related things.
Right.
They say we forget things, how can I sit for the examination? That type of doubtfulness about their ability, that type of thing.
Yes.
Ordinary public, mild mental disorders,
yes.
It is called anxiety disorders.
Okay.
It's a huge family of disorders.
Family disorders, yes.
Yeah. The person will not die, but the person will suffer entire life.
Right.
That is why the bad thing of the anxiety disorders.
Yes.
But then the family-related things.
Family-related.
Yeah. These all, our clinical picture is, it's this type of mix one.
Yes. So at which point someone should seek professional help if they, it could be ourselves or it could be a friend or a family member. So when should we decide that we need to seek professional help?
Yeah, actually, if they have a difficulty, if they come early as, possible is much better.
Yes.
Because cure is short-term cure.
Short-term cure.
It is easy to cure.
Yes.
But it took for many years. But if it is 2-3 years, 5 years, 10 years, it take more time to cure. More time to cure.
Yes.
Because the psychological disorders also, it is like some growing plants.
Yes.
With the time also, it can grow. There is a possibility.
Yes.
That is why early treatment is better.
Early treatment is better.
Yeah.
Yes. So, Professor, what is your advice to our viewers?
Actually, advice is to read about the international articles and books in over the now internet.
Yes.
And to find out the professional association and contact them.
Yes.
You can have a visit and talk to them without any fee, you can visit.
Okay.
Yeah, you can ask. I came to know about counseling.
Okay.
We don't charge anything.
Okay.
John Gaya Memorial Counseling Center. We don't charge. You can discuss what type of service, how do you do these things.
Right.
We invite anybody to come and talk to us.
Okay. So, Professor, thank you very much for joining with us today.
You're welcome.
So, dear friends, we hope you learned something from this discussion and hope you apply it to your life. If you think it's something you cannot handle alone, reach us. We are here to help you with both emotional and legal advice. Write to us at help@knowyourrights.lk or send us a Facebook message whenever you have a query and actively get involved in this forum. I'm Rajeevi Mapalagama and thanks for joining with Know Your Rights. We'll be meeting you soon again and discussing more on this topic. Thank you.
For more information, visit us at www.knowyourrights.lk or visit our Facebook page, Know Your Rights SL, or email us at help@knowyourrights.lk.